Life incites challenges. These challenges happen because we're going through a certain transition in life, where our old life is ceasing to exist and a new life awaits for us. One of the things I've learned is that we're always one choice away from a different life, and with every choice we make, will lead us to that life. That's something that not only I, but many others had to go through. The process of acceptance is hard, yet not impossible. Though when there's a challenge going on in our lives, we tend to go through this acceptance process. I want to use relationship as an example for this process. Number one, shock. Say that you're in a committed relationship with someone that was honest and loyal to you. Feeling loved by someone is one of the greatest feelings in life, until you get a phone call. A sudden yet unexpected event happens in a relationship, causing the separation of one another. This example, along with many other examples, can vary on the situation. These situations can lead us to the end of an old life that we once lived, to a start of a new beginning. But the process doesn't end there. Number two, denial. We tend to deny that the situation didn't happen or that it has never had an impact in our lives. It is in our nature to deny these things and try our best to move on, but as we hold in our emotions, it tends to build up and then the next step arrives. Number three, anger. I climbed through all of the ceilings. Secretly, I know yet there's no way to find it. Anger has its factors. If it's not used constructively, then it could be used destructively, which often has a negative result. Anger is an emotion that we all have. Like all of our other emotions, anger has the power to not only have an impact on ourselves, but the environment we choose to surround ourselves in. Environment meaning the people, our friends, our family, and so on. Anger has the power to have an effect on us internally as we fight an internal battle against our emotions within ourselves. As the battle progresses, it takes a toll on our mentality and our emotions, which leads up to the next point. Number four, depression. As our battle leads us down to the lowest part of our life, we tend to feel down and sad, which leads us down to depression. Depression seems to be the hardest part in our lives because we tend to have this internal conflict within ourselves. Here I am, the lowest part of my life. Nowhere to go, nothing I can do about it. All these emotions has led us down to this point in life, a point of no return, making us discouraged and giving up. Number five, transition. But when there's a problem in our lives, then we have to fix it or get rid of it in order to live a better life. This is where transitioning comes in. One of the hardest obstacles in life is to take the first step out of the state of depression and climb out of the bottom of the pit. Climbing out of the situation that led to your downfall can help build you up to become a stronger person later on in life. What used to be a problem can now be a solution and can be prevented if we choose to acknowledge that what happened was in the past and remember not to repeat it again. And then as we climb our way up, we finally come to a conclusion. Number 6. Acceptance. It's time to say goodbye to our old life. The situation that happened in the past was very harsh. It has developed us to people who we are today. Once we accept what happened was in the past, new doors open and finally a new life awaits, and you're at a higher point than you were ever before. How can we get through a situation quicker? Well, be thankful for who and what you have in your life, no matter how big or how small. As long as they promote a positive lifestyle and are a positive influence in your life and create those cherishable memories, then we can get through those harder times quicker and faster than before. Life is very limited, but the things we can do is limitless. Live life cherishable, happy, and be thankful for what you have.